That's better. I should have used this. Boy. So this. Oh God. So this is the one that can be changed. Okay, that makes sense. Sorry, my comprehension is wrong actually. This is much more fine than I expected. So you can potentially yep, I was right. There's a fine thread. It's not just pull up and down, it's more of rotation. So for me, I want to rotate it as close as possible so that it can focus in the furthest distance. At least that's how I comprehend in the thinnest. In my comprehension, and there's something moving with it. I guess that's what happened when I dropped it. I dropped this lens when I bought it on the trip to taking a Milky Way shot. I bet that's what happened. What happened to this lens? It just doesn't. Okay, so that's something new. I take out the ring. To stabilize something. So the whole thing move, and this move with it. Okay. It's weird. I mean, I'm of course not the producer of this. I'm not a, you know, extreme expert of that. I just know the basic concept as a physicist. But no offense to the company, why they make this two rings? I guess easier to manufacture. Otherwise, it's just redundant to add that ring in it. Okay, whatever. Oh, this is for, sorry, my mistake. This is to coupling with this so that so that they can point it out which focal distance it is. So that is basically alignment. Okay, can I focus further? No. Reassemble, now I understand the mechanism. I bet the 155 means something. Maybe 155 degree or something in that manner. So this is maybe the opposite rotation. Has opposite thread. Yep. Off of this thread. Technically, this will work. This definitely will focus on infinity, but no promises on the closer things. Well, who cares? This lens is for taking photo of galaxy for me. I mean, you know, this is not, you know, some high-tech stuff that I can take of further galaxy. I'm talking about, you know, Milky Way. Yeah. cover. Remember this is here. Oh yeah, by the way, there's the four screws. If you miss the orientation, the yeah, as you can see, I did screw it up and break it. So those things, like, designed to have a certain orientation. If this orientation on this side is messed up, technically you will see the shadow of this, which I encountered before. That's why I know. Yeah, final cleanup before I seal everything. Yeah, this one is easy. So orientation is set, the dot is for the dot, so yep. There you go, that's how you... Oh, sorry. And this, and then this part, you need to make sure that is... This need to be in the correct direction. So I just move it to the extreme, like here, infinity, or for me, 0.028 meter, then it will be here will be the correct position. So I will just need to screw it down to have that secured, and it's all set. The rest of it should be easy. Yeah, by the way, if I fix this, then that means I don't need to buy another expensive lens. And also, I think the good things of a cheap lens, third-party lens, is that it's cheap enough, I don't feel the pain of buying a, of destroying it. I mean, if I destroy this lens, what's a big deal? I learned something. There you go. That's disassemble and reassemble lens.